just leave the Weaver 1v1 versus the Batrider, maybe after a decent, just decent start.
Hey, you forgot to take off the tag, dude.
And now it's probably more so the fact that they'll go for like, something with a disable on this on their secondary support.
Oh, the Alchemist! Look at this!
This is Alchemist City.
Sanking
support against Scepter Osprey. They seem to like the sanking on the fourth row a lot, so yeah, they're gonna roam with the sanking.
And it's good versus the illusion spam that we were kind of talking about before.
Greedy
and
though.
It is a bit greedy, yeah. But it, you know, it gives them the lockdown. They don't really have that much without like a Golem or the Batrider Lasso on top of that. So.
Okay, this is it. It's crunch time. Yep. We are going to a third series as expected when these two teams were going to clash. The draft is done, it's locked in, and that means they're about to load in to their third game of the series. Not a single Chinese team has managed to make it to the quarterfinals yet. Will Newbie be the first, or will AdFinum go ahead and continue this Cinderella story? From the first in the EU regional qualifiers to perhaps getting to the quarterfinals. We'll find out as their biggest event does continue, or will Newbie stop it? Find out with your casters as once again Cap and Melini are standing by.
Everyone knew that AdFinum versus Newbie would be one hell of a match, and we are indeed going to get a game three, where this time around, AdFinum are going to place their hopes on one big carry. It's going to be Thug's Alchemist rather than Madara this time around. Can AdFinum actually persevere through a little bit of versatility there, banking on an Alchemist pick like that?
Especially with the Shadow Demon, I think it's... Alchemist has just been so difficult to deal with.
Newbie,
when Newbie saw them draft, it's like,
he definitely got to be a little bit of a slump. Just like, oh god, we have to deal with an Alchemist on the main stage in a third game in an elimination match on top of everything else. AdFinum, quite the upstarts, but Newbie still have a very good team fight lineup, and they have some good counters to the Alchemist as well. Most notably, Etsy's Timbersaw is going to be one to look out for, and his play in the middle lane. He is already a bit countered by the Nyx Assassin that was already in AdFinum's hand for Skylark. They have that against both a Batrider and a Timbersaw, but he's going to need a much better performance than some of the initiations we saw in Game 2, because they are going to have a much harder time creating space for Thug than Madara had on that Morphling, right? He got a free lane. He had like a free game for the first 15 minutes.
Yep, that's where the Shadow Demon Morana comes in, and they're already looking to get a surprise first blood on the bottom lane. Madara, he's kind of feigning that he's down there alone, and generally you want to contest first Alchemist, but they have no idea what the other four are. And with Morana in the game, it's very easy to concede a first blood. So a KB will scout it out and just immediately bounce them. Yeah, you have to give Alk a bounty rune, but that's better than giving him first blood.
Yeah, it certainly is. He will quickly pick up the beginning of his Iron Talon and a little bit of helping hand with that healing sound. This is something different, though. AdFinum are going to go for a smoke straight off the bat. As they pick up that Bounty Rune, Nyx Assassin, the Shadow Demon, and the Morana are going to be heading up to top lane. They're going to try and give Skylark a nice, easy start to his lane, which is normally quite tough against both a Warlock and a Luna. They're lining things up right now, letting Spartan be the leading initiator, and they're wrapping around behind Faith. Faith is going to be the one caught. Disruption leading into an Impale, leading into an Arrow, and that'll be the easiest first blood of AdFinum's life here at the main stage.
And an important one for them, as they need to set the pace for the game for the Alchemist. And one thing that was not touched upon is that Kaka is on the Batrider, and yep. Kaka is the support player. So he is going to be, he was napalming mid. I was like, what? What is he doing over there? But he's support. They switched it up in the last minute, throwing KP on the Sand King. And
he gets arrowed yet again. No need for disruption here. Kaka, who leveled up Sticky Napalm to try and harass that Alchemist in the mid lane, is in serious trouble. Maybe next time, trying to body block him. They'll also have the disruption into the impale once again. AdFinum's teamwork looking spot on here.
And he doesn't even knock off the clarity.
2-0. The Alchemist may be feeling the pressure of SC's Timbersaw and a little bit of help from that Batrider, but this aggro tri-lane situation is certainly working out for AdFinum. Skylark's going to have quite the early level 2. Skylark running into U9 here. They're going to try and trim back themselves away. Spartan is going to be able to get the disruption. Skylark just tries to get out, it looks like, and Kaka's actually stuck here. The disruption blocking him in, but doesn't really matter. More importantly, Ben. That was a courier pickoff. Maybe next time. You thought just because he wasn't on a bounty hunter, you thought he wasn't going to pick off couriers? No.
They don't have a good way to catch him. There's like no disruptor to bring them back. Like neither of their supports have disable, silences, nothing. So maybe next time can just run wherever he wants. He was just there arrowing the large troll camp, just making sure that there's no stack coming out from the Batrider. And support Batrider is tough, especially when they're all up in your jungle. Yeah. I've seen jungle Batriders before, but support is another. Is another beast.
Oh, maybe next time. What are you doing? Lines up on that arrow, surprise in the trees, but SC, the soldier, ever vigilant, manages to just barely sidestep that arrow.
Skylar was taking a lot of damage on the top lane, but it's okay. Pop a branch.
So was KP. Look at this guy. Without a courier, he's in that awkward situation where he wants to be able to stay in lane because it's a 1v1. He doesn't want to leave out any experience, but he is also... has no backup when it comes to regen. He's finally got his side to suicide in neutrals, it looks like. But this does leave Madara a free lane, something that, mid, bug dropping a bit low, but SC, without having level 6, really doesn't have solo kill potential against an Alchemist.
Timber is crushing him in CS. Almost double Alchemist right now, and that's with the early bounty rune going his way. And Timbersaw, just a very, very great matchup, and SCCC very skilled in that mid lane. Dire has used Scan, they did sense it out, but the arrow is spot on.
SC going to be blocked up. He does have high levels of reactive armor right now. They're going to leap and try and get that extra bit of damage, just not enough.
Yeah, one downside about having the disruption is that you have the illusions. If you wanted them to attack, you're popping reactive armor stacks on the Timbersaw. And that's a gank that they really wanted to work out over here.
Skylark, thanks to the space of the two supports, is doing pretty well for himself. He is actually going to man up against Faith, manages to catch the creep wave in the process, and he's actually going to pull it into this hard camp knowingly. That does put him in a spot when it comes to those fatal bonds, and he'll actually miss one of those last hits. But in the end, this will be a lane that pushes forward, and Skylark will be able to get what seemingly a fast level 6. Rana's coming over. They actually lay down... I really like this ward here for newbie. It's spawning out maybe next time, movements around the map. This will give SC an idea that there's probably another arrow coming his way, or maybe just a neutral.
And Kaka's really deep in the Radiant jungle. Maybe part of his job is to stop the stacking. Kaka, is he going to spawn out?
Nope. Spartan's going to be caught. Burrow strike into all this sticky napalm. Spartan really doesn't stand a snowball's chance in hell, not with all this fire around. Newbie finally get themselves on the board here, 2-1.
Yeah, and Kaka does have an observer ward over here, so this can give them more control of the Radiant jungle because of how deeply Adphenom's invading their own. They need more places to farm on Newbie. You want the Batrider takes up a decent amount of space if you actually want him to get items.
Right.
And right now he's just stacking, he's not stacking, he's just scouting out the Alchemist and trying to steal his stacks possibly. So that's kind of a cool, unique ability that the Batrider can do, is steal opponent stacks, which is definitely something that we're going to be seeing this game.
Thug was trying to pick up his level 6 off the jungle, but with Kaka in range, he sapped some of that experience, and Thug is really feeling the pressure of SC now, especially now that SC has his level 6. The Chakram is up. This does give him kill potential against Thug. But Thug will also have his level 6, it seems, with this creep wave. No opportunity to be found for newbie just yet.
Yeah, maybe next time just trying to figure out where this Batrider is. And getting some stacks up for Alk, and Alk also in the meantime getting top rune. Will it be bounty? Nope, just a haste rune for him. He will stack up the ancients in the meantime.
Bit unlucky, but we'll see whether or not that haste rune comes in play for him. Maybe it'll save his life against an incoming gank from newbie. They are freely farming on U9, but so is Madara. He's got 35 and 10 compared to the Sand King's 18 and 0. KP has given himself a solo lane where he's got free experience, but he's not able to keep up when it comes to levels.
Arrow, Spartan, will it arrow? Connect?
A bit too late.
Yeah, he was a little bit too far behind. He probably had to leap, and even if he left, I don't think that he would have been able to get that kill.
No.
Very hard to kill this Batrider when he's in the trees.
Still though, how is this Batrider going to be effective? He's level 3, 6.5 minutes in. It doesn't seem like they're going to really be able to rely on stacks. What do you think newbie's idea is to be able to give him at least some semblance of farm?
Well, maybe they swap into the support role because they realize that, okay, it's going to be kind of countered by the next assassin, and they want to fight much earlier because you need to shut down Alchemist very, very early on. So now he's playing... Kaka is known for playing like a bounty hunter Riki, so now he's just getting a lot of intel around the map, just dropping his rewards, kind of playing deep onto Adfinim's side, just like the two supports were in the early game. So they're not playing him for Lassos, they're not playing him for Napalm Stacks. It's just be annoying, get some kills around the map, and just be ever so elusive with the Firefly up clips.
He's certainly foreseeing rotations here. Adfinim double TP in. One of them, though, is Skylark. He's level 6. U9 is actually pushing out his lane, so they should have free info about the Nyx Assassin moving around the map at this point in time.
I don't know if they have enough damage. He has a fair amount of armor, so the Vendetta and plus the Swarm, it's going to be pretty difficult.
Lead with Vendetta, or maybe an Impale does catch him during the Sandstorm, but will be enough. He has a Burrow Strike, that's why Skylark puts himself forward with the Spike Carapace. KP will go farther down the river, but he tries to go for a TP out. It's just not going to happen, though. Both an Arrow, a Disruption, and all the right-click damage you could ask for comes out from Adfinim for third kill.
Yeah, that was a tough gank for KP in this game. Like, even if he had Burrowed up the cliff, yep, and then tried to TP, he still had a Swarm on him, so there's very little chance of him being able to TP out with full vision into an Arrow. And maybe next time, probably trying to get lucky with a courier kill as he heads up to the Dire Secret Shop, but there's no courier to be spotted.
Still, though, all those rotations do give newbie a free chance to push down a tier 1 tower. Luna safely farming in lane is not just at 52 and 9 when it comes to CS, but it's also able to pick up a tower last hit as well.
So they need Warlock 6 before they can actually start pushing towers together as 5, and Sand King is a long way away from Blink Dagger, as is the Batrider, but it looks like they're going to try and prioritize the Batrider, or at least he's going to be stacking for one of the two, as they try and look for ways to perhaps force engagements while Alchemist is off farming.
So do you think that newbie actually go for these pushes with the Warlock Ultimate, or do you think they have to wait for one of those Blink Daggers first?
I think they can go with the Warlock Ultimate. Like, Weaver is kind of Murana SD is very good at getting kills, but poor in an actual team fight. Nyx Assassin is the only one that they're worried about, but with Timbersaw being super farmed and Warlock and Fatal Bonds and Eclipse, I think that's enough to take a team fight, especially with no BKBs and no items really. If the Alchemist joins a fight though, then they could actually be in a little bit of trouble. Like, if he's stalling with the Acid Spray, they don't have that great of sustain, nor do they have that much armor to really counter it, and no signs of an early mech from a newbie. So I think it all depends on whether or not, like, the Alchemist is around there. They can't push the Alchemist lane.
Yeah, it is quite dangerous to try and continue to just separate and farm up those Blink Daggers, because this just gives Skylark more opportunity for potential picks on this Nyx Assassin. Now, he just spent a majority of his Vendetta in bottom lane, didn't actually get an opportunity for a kill there, but now he's going to rotate over and try and catch SC. SC trying to contest the rune, but Thug will manage to pick up an Arcane, and Arrow nails him from behind, and they're going to be able to combo up these stuns quite nicely. SC not going to be able to make it out of here. Spartan's going to be able to get the extra kill, looks like. They don't have a stun up. Impale is down, but the Spike Carapace will hold Kaka there for a moment. But really, once he's into the cliff, it's very hard for these heroes to be able to catch Kaka.
And they just all got Fatal Bonded and have to be very careful about that. Kaka, as Firefly is right about to run out, he can pop an Impale, but no follow-up.
Man, with this support Murana, it's just so hard for them to actually utilize the jungle efficiently. They maybe next time just keeps on making these entrances, takes away the big creep out of some of these hard camps, and newbie are left a whole lot less effective with heroes like the Sand King and Batrider, who are known for being able to have some jungling prowess.
Mm-hmm. And surprisingly, no tome up for newbie. It's been a minute since it spawned, yet looks like Warlock is trying to do it the hard way by just sitting in lane.
Yeah, they're
the
going
Luna.
For
there's a smoke.
They're pushing bottom lane, and they're also going to smoke up with two members of newbie. Actually, three members. This puts a lot off map.
What a
scam. Yeah, this is so obvious to Adfinim. So many members of Adfinim off map, and a Luna pushing in bottom. They realize the rotation is coming in from mid lane to bottom lane, and it looks like no one is really going to be caught here. Madara kind of showing himself, but he's got the Shikuchi. He can afford to play a bit of a dangerous game there with the newbie cores. backs himself away. Nubier's still going to go for that push, but Skylark's already in position. He's got the creep wave and soul liquid up, so they may actually be able to make a trade-off here while still keeping efficiency on map.
And Madara, he's walking into a ward.
That is too much of a dangerous game, my friend. He's just going to get bursted down. Thought he could rely on the time-lapse, but one stun and one sentry is all that's needed to be able to bring him low. The TP out from KP is he's actually going to try and contest this tier 1 tower, at least try and go for the deny. Skylark does manage to take it, thanks in part to the spike carapace. KP waits it out, though. Does manage to get the stun, but the epicenter is going to be hard to track as Skylark gets himself out of the way with a Vendetta. Now he's actually still trying to set up on KP because from the south, Spartan is going to try and cut KP off. KP doesn't have a whole lot of mana to work with, no magic stick charges. If Spartan can just hit the purge, I think this is going to be enough. KP already brought low. One nuke is all it should take. A couple of right clicks and the purge can easily finish him off. The TP in from the Luna will not be able to save him. Can't even get any damage out in the Skylark as he blocks it all back with another beautifully timed spike carapace.
They all almost could have killed the Luna right there if they had set up a disruption into an arrow on him, and maybe it looks like that's what they're aiming for. They don't have vision of her as she goes to the right side of the map. They don't have a ward up onto that side, but with the trees cut down, is it going to get caught?
They do have the Eclipse, but he doesn't get it off in time. Now they're going to be able to combo stuns up. No, he actually sidesteps the arrow. He can actually turn with the Warlock drop of the Chaotic Offering. They're going to be able to blow up the Shadow Demon. It seems like catch the Nyx Assassin as well. He turns for an impale, but it doesn't matter. Run down by newbies heroes as they bait out U9.
Perfect use of the Warlock ultimate, and Luna kind of hesitated on whether or not she should have popped the Eclipse, but no fear, Newbie's team was back there to behind her, and wasting not 1 second, they smoke up, immediately head over to the Radiant Ancients and hope to look for a low HP Alchemist. He's at 1200 gold with a Relic card.
Oh, and his Chemical Rage, it's just about to fall. So he's in serious trouble, not just close to the Radiance, but also at his ultimately exposed area. Going to be caught here by the... they're going to be able to catch up, but the disruption goes down first. The lasso and its damage is going to be a bit ineffective. Murana tries to put a stop to it, but ultimately they do manage to get that kill. Can they catch anybody in the process, though? A TP's coming in from the Nyx Assassin, trying to put himself in front of the Batrider with a spike carapace, and he will manage to at least catch one, but that is still slowing down the Radiance, and they only traded what is a support Batrider.
He managed to pick up the Radiance recipe before he died, so
oh, he did.
Not the worst trade in the world, but Newbie's still coming out. We're good, 600 gold ahead.
Newbie know they have to keep up the pace when it comes to this tempo of ganks. They need to constantly put pressure on this Alchemist, otherwise they're going to be on the losing side of a split push war.
And it looks like Spartan will be able to get these two D wards. It's so important as the Radiant really needs to farm those Ancients up. It's just really important for the Alchemist. Even the Weaver can help a lot with the Swarm, but not if there's no creeps there. And Newbie probably taking a look at their economic game. They use a lot of smokes, hasn't yielded the most kills, and both their Blink Dagger wielders are not
KP nailed
there.
Up maybe next time with a beautiful rotation to bottom lane. Red KP's rotation beautifully, but oh my god, he just burst rugged into the trees. They're going to be able to come in with the Eclipse, blows up maybe next time, and they actually survive on KP and get a counter kill.
That's a huge play from KP right there. And a little bit late on the dust. I don't think the Shikuchi damage hit the Sand King as he was running away to the north side. And that would have halted most of the blink progression. And now it looks like Newbie will follow that up with another tower.
Newbie, they've taken all the important objectives here. If they can actually translate this into not just a tier 2 tower kill, but also start putting pressure on mid, the Alchemist is going to be struggling to find space to farm.
He's walking into a trap. Madara walked into the center.
Oh, but he runs right back out. Lasso not going to be in there in time. He uses time lapse just in case. He goes right back through them again, taunting them to chase him down because he has the help of the rest of his team this time around. Advin, I'm going to come forward. They missed one stun. U9 thought he could TP out. Thinks better of it. His arrow slides on by. Now he has to turn and fight, but he knows he's dead. The purge just keeps him from escaping. They managed to catch Kaka there with the spike carapace, slowing down his retreat. Madara does have view of him. Another spike carapace is coming up. Skylark gets him once again. The impale will put a stop to that TP. And 8-6 now is the score as Ad Finem do manage to hold that tier 2 tower.
That was just not the real good fight that they were looking for. So KP and they think the stun duration is long enough, but it wasn't a max duration. And the dust comes out. He doesn't hit with the Shikuchi damage, and he blinks into an impossible area for them to scout, unless you leap right on top of him or they have a swarm. That's another thing. The dust came out late, so the swarm wasn't able to stick on top of the Sand King.
8-6, 16 and a half minutes in, a 4,000 gold lead for Advenom, 2,000 experience. KD gonna be caught by another arrow from Baby next time. This time around, he preemptively ducks. He does not want to let KD escape again. He tries to put him on this cliff, doesn't quite make it, but the TP, it won't get out in time. Disruption stops him, and KP will fall 9-6 now.
And his current gold right before that, 1850.
Oh, man. He gets knocked down to 1500, and he's out of the game for 40 seconds. This Blink Dagger is just not going to be coming up anytime soon, and neither will the Batriders. He's only sitting at 1300. And this is really necessary. They need that hard initiation for newbie to feel confident pushing the last remaining of these objectives, right? The tier one and tier two is really what helps the alchemist maintain security around these farming areas, these two neutral camps, as well as this ancient area.
And even despite those two heroes not really close to our Blink Dagger, newbie, they do have the Midas on the Warlock. Fate's been a little bit quiet, but only one death. That's a pretty good sign for him and involved in a decent amount of kills. So even if they don't have the Blink Daggers up early and maybe four steps later, they probably will have the Ags Warlock later to help them out in their late game situation.
Yeah, it looks like U9 is planning on spending a lot of time farming against this Alchemist. He goes ahead and picks up the Helm of Dominator. They're going to try and keep control of their own ancient camp and utilize it against the Alchemist. They can't keep pace, obviously, but they can at least keep within within striking distance of Madara's net worth. Sitting AK. Oh, the arrow could have come out. Maybe next time. How does he keep on landing these? Skylark holds on to the spike carapace until he was in the perfect spot, too. Just in case, but really, maybe next time. Didn't need that extra backup. He's able to land these arrows all by himself, it seems.
And Alchemist bottles another bounty rune. And right now, it's just an economic war.
Yeah.
Can these guys get their Blink Daggers and kill some of Advenom's heroes so that the Alchemist is the only problem that they have to worry about? Right now, is like the Nyxus has had Blink Dagger for quite some time now. They still have to buy a lot of Sentry Wards, a lot of Reveal, so that they can see this Weaver and perhaps see the Nyxus Assassin as he's Vendetta around the map. But, I mean, Faith is kind of the only one farming that well of the three that you kind of are worried about in this game.
Maybe this is why U9 did pick up that Helm of Dominator. Maybe he thinks these Blink Daggers are just not going to come fast enough. They're not going to be able to maintain map control fast enough. And Alchemist will ultimately win out first when it comes to this economic game. He'll be able to have that Manta before newbie can end it. They are going to be able to do a four-man smoke wraparound here. The two supports in mid lane, they are going to be the victims, or at least one of them here. Spartan on the Shadow Demon finds himself a momentary reprieve, but the disruption ultimately will not pay. Tier 1 tower is going to fall because of that. Advenom will gladly give it up, though. Looks like they have enough space for the taking. Madara is pushing out the top lane, and Thug is trying to get that bottom lane pushed out while newbie pushed to tier 2.
The Blink Dagger reveal does yield them a T1, but not sure if that's enough. And Alchemist, in the meantime, is still just off farming like a madman. And the push will be slowed down because of the swarm.
Yeah, and how do you actually stop Madara when he shows himself like this? If they go ahead and use this fresh Blink Dagger from KP to Burrow Strike, it just gets blocked out by the Lincoln. So, oh! The Razor dies just in time, and U9 is actually set up underneath this Tier 1 tower. SC pushes back at Venom, making sure they can't do much with that Moonlight Shadow.
Maybe next time walks under the Sentry Ward. They don't have vision on him yet, but they perhaps see that all of Advenom are on the south side.
And the Manta's up, and the illusions start coming out. Both Disruption as well as Manta illusions. The Radiance Burn, it seems like, is going to be enough to keep their Tier 2 safe. Newbie are going to be pushed back. They need to find pickoffs from here on out before they go for these full-out pushes. Bounty Rune going to be jumped, but it may cost KP his life. He gets stunned up, but he also Burrow Strikes out. Gets a little bit distance away from Madara. He's going to be chased down. He doesn't have Burrow Strike, no Sandstorm, nothing. He is going to be chased down underneath his Tier 1 tower. Time-lapse, and Madara. Hit and run for him, getting the 11 kill for Advenom.
Now they're really desperate when it comes to the gold. Their HOD creep just got arrowed, and they're about to lose a T1 tower, which doesn't leave the Ancients really safe for U9 to take anymore. They need to create gold out of nowhere, which is kind of what the stacking from the HOD does, but if they can't take that out, and then they still need the Blink Dagger on the Batrider, and then you also need the Timber and the Luna to absorb a lot of the creeps, I just see them falling further and further behind. They need more picks, as you mentioned, with two or three while the others are farming.
The Blink Dagger just picked up for Kaka is going to be enough for him to blink away. Yes, it is! Skylark, if he was there a second or two earlier, they could have even stopped that Blink Dagger from being purchased by Kaka. But as it is, Newbie had both their initiating items. Will it be enough, though?
They're out of smokes as the Zerva Ward spots at least the Sand King out, and Adfinim are way out of there. And now, Adfinim, all they really want to do is let Newbie push into them. If they're pushing into them, they're together as five. They waste their time because of the constant barrage of Alchemist illusions. And if they don't push as five, they'll just get out farmed. So maybe Newbie should tend towards that Dire Ancient area. That Dire Ancient area is where they will make their money, as well as perhaps taking Roshan. I think their team fight is still way stronger. Batrider with a Blink Dagger is very strong. Alchemist Illusions, I don't think they actually pinged it out, but with that drawn by maybe next time, it looks like they are well aware that a smoke is coming. Just not which direction. Skylark will pop the smoke.
They do have dust. Batrider runs the wrong direction, blinks onto his spike carapace. Not able to catch Skylark just yet. They bounce him forward instead of backwards. He gets an impale off. The dust is wearing low. They will manage to catch him, but they're in a nasty position. They're inside the secret shop. They're going to try and play the high ground here. The jump forward. Madara is going to be caught by the chaotic offering, but does manage to time lapse it off. They also jump forward onto Spartan, but the Batrider's already down. He clips moving forward, does manage to clean up Spartan. Maybe next time leaps himself barely out of it, but the Luna is almost down. He gets burned out by the Radiance, and Madara searches for more. The Sand King and the Timbersaw, they might have gotten maybe next time, but they are dropped dangerously low. Alchemist is going to be able to come in, hit them with a concoction. That's a Timbersaw dead. A big kill for Adfinim as they pick up their fourth kill in exchange for their two supports in an offlane.
What a slick play from Thug right there. He BOT'd. He wasn't that close to the Timbersaw, so he casted Unstable Concoction, BOT'd on a creep that was already moving towards the Timbersaw, and just bursted him down right as he was on top of them. And the Alchemist Illusions are just a little bit too much to handle. They had to blow so much to take the Nyx Assassin, but they were in a very compromising position, all clumped up to the north side of the Ancients, and Alchemists and Weaver thrive in that sort of environment when you're choked up. And Weaver got a decent amount of swarms on this. So Lasso comes out, there's just bugs everywhere, and they're already at low armor from the acid spray, combating that with a swarm, and Madara's free to clean up. U9, he's at the bottom. He can't really do that much damage with Eclipse because of his positioning, and this BOT play from maybe next time, or from Thug, as they're trying to chase down SCCC was pretty big.
I mean, the fact that Skylark bought so much time there, and it put Newbie in such an aggressive position. They were just begging to slowly be chipped away by that, the damage over time. Thug, you could see the way that he kind of played the outer edges of that team fight, burning away at Newbie with that Radiance as he does so now, revealing five members right next to the Roshan pit. Quick denying that bounty rune, denying it away from Thug.
They need this area. If they lose this area, they'll lose the game. And look at the net worth graph. He's 22,000 versus the 10,000 of the Timbersaw and the Luna. So, like, them two combined is still less than the Alchemist. And there are axe carriers in this game. Nyx Assassin, very good. Weaver, if you want to make the Alchemist even stronger, like, Mirana can transition into a core, although she's building a scepter herself. So, like, they still have a lot of room to grow. And maybe
he wasn't credible enough. SD, no vigilance here. KP's going to be caught as well by the impale. He tried to blink in and get a burrow strike off, but Skylark strikes first. This offlaner beginning to shine now for Adfinim. They're going to be able to run down some extra heroes. Poor Fate, he knows that he's done for. He sees Thug big and bad. Running forward on the Alchemist claims that double kill. And presumably, Adfinim will be able to get an objective out of this as well. It's going to be Roshan. What they're going to be attempting here, Newbie, without their big teamfight ultimates of both the Epicenter and Chaotic Offering, seem unlikely to be able to contest this, particularly with the heavy damage of Adfinim. They try and come in, and Steve's just not going to be there in time for a Chakram. The Roshan will go down, and an Aegis picked up by the Alchemist. Now they're actually trying to turn. Skylark does stun up Kaka. They almost finish him off. They need a little bit more burn damage to make Kaka's sacrifice worth it. SC's going to be chased down by Monera at the same time. They disruption. Thog going to be pulled up by the cliff, but he does bounce back down over to Madara as he's still trying to chase down SC. KP thought about an Epicenter, started charging up. He cancels instead, opting for the stun, and that is going to be able to get the kill on Madara without the ultimate.
Epicenter a little bit reckless as they move in, probably really happy about getting yet another chicken kill, but going in way too deep without the help of the Alchemist. Alchemist does not have the mobility that the Weaver has. Not that much increased move speed, no Blink Dagger, no Shadow Blade, no anything to go to where the Weaver was, all the way to the T2 tower. And they were already preoccupied killing the bat.
Yeah, and SC, he does have quite a large amount of armor to contend with that Desolator of Madara's. He's got both reactive armor as well as the just plain plate mail.
now he's going for the BKB. And the only damage they have through BKB is Luna. And Luna is still very underfarmed and does not have a BKB of her own. There's a Manta style, but I mean, Alchemist is just huge. He can easily just right-click those a couple of times and they will all die. And there seems to be a lot more damage coming out from Adfinim as maybe next time closes in on the last component of his eggs.
I was just about to talk about, like, he's got the six items, so he... U9, he's going to be caught here. Beautiful setup here by Skylark, and maybe next time. They're trying to force out something, force rotations, but they don't fully commit to that kill on the Luna. They back themselves away. Adfinim are actually going to back up.
That's a lot of discipline.
And
you can tell that they really want to win this.
Yeah,
like, normally you're just like, we'll go for it, even if we die worth, right? Because Luna, but
yeah,
you know, they know that they don't want to concede any other kills, at least give someone the Axe before. And who did he?
Oh, Hero nailed him! He caught him on the right side of the map. Batrider thought he was going to be in position for a Firefly, but it's going to be Adfinim who catch him first. The smoke rotation of Adfinim works out. They're going to be able to push into this tier 2 tower now, as it's going to be Newbie scrambling along the outer edges of the map looking for a split push.
I think the Axe is going to be complete. They can just give it to Nyx Assassin and just park it up on the top side of the kill. And what can they really do? So let's see. Thug.
Is it Axe? Is it Madara?
Oh, you get it to Madara. Okay.
Yeah. Madara's going to be able to have that time lapse, which is in some ways even better, right? Because now they can park Thug up on the high ground. He has Aegis, and even if they eat through that, there's going to be a time lapse coming in as well.
And defensive disrupting. So that's like pretty much 4 lives for Alchemist.
Dominant position for Adfinim as they go high ground here. Thug is going to be forced out deeper into the base, slow down a bit. They do still have that chaotic offering to be dropped, but Thug is making it so hard for Faith. He's already down to half HP. And that tier 3 about to fall. These illusions just will not stop. They keep on battering into these heroes. Faith is knocked all the way back to the fountain here, as now they're beginning to be on the melee right. With the help of Madara, they're going to be able to go on SC. SC drop low. KP trying to interrupt, though, with the Burrow Strike. Will allow SC to retreat, but now it's 4 members of Newbie ready to fight while SC is going to reach and up. This means their melee Rax is going to be forfeited.
They can't even kill the illusions.
They can't. They're just way too big.
That's depressing. That's really depressing. All the supports just have to run away, and that was just the disruption illusions, let alone the Manta illusions, let alone the rest of Adfinim's heroes. So there was just very little chance of them actually killing the Alchemist, and there's still a minute left on this Aegis, and they have creeps in the mid lane, so don't even have to worry about backdoor protection.
Madara heading back for his BKB and uses his time lapse to come right back. Beating on this tier 2 tower, Adfinim still
Arrow
have that Aegis.
Oh, Faith.
No way! Are they gonna go for it? No, they're just gonna let the illusions do their work. Maybe they can force Faith back to the fountain once again.
They need a big combo. Sand King, Epicenter into Fatal Bonds, Warlock. That's pretty much all they can do. There is still no BKB on the Alchemist, nor...
Jump forward, there's their initiation. Immediately stop. Skylar in place with the Spike Carapace. They try and drop the Chaotic Offering, catching multiple heroes here, but Thug is right in the middle of all these heroes, and they're dropping low. Thug, he's hit by the Eclipse, brought down as SC gets the jump onto him, but still, Madara comes forward with his BKB. He's already cleaned up Faith, and Thug, this is round 2 with him. He's got his ultimate ready to go. They've got time-lapse as well. Madara's just sitting in the back, ready to go. If they jump on Thug, this time around, they don't have their big ults.
That was everything that they had. I don't think Newbie have what it takes to fend off this just over-farmed Alchemist.
Skylark jumping forward, does manage to catch U9. They're gonna combo stun him. KP just can't do anything about it. His Blink Dagger constantly stopped by Thug's illusion. They're gonna buy back on U9. But KP is so low and struggling to be able to find space to be able to charge up an Epicenter and find a Blink. So at Venom, they see the melee Raxus down, a buyback force. They back themselves away in a domineering position.
And Newbie, what do they have left to do at this point? I'm trying to think of ways they can get back in the game. They've already lost 2 melee Raxus, and there's still plenty of eggs left to be given on the Alchemist. So looking at this, they're trying to set up for a big combo over here as KP tries to follow up with a rock. But look at that 3-man stun coming out from Skylark, and Thug is at the front. Madara has used time lapse early, so can't use it on Thug right before he pops the Aegis. But no one died during that ultimate.
Spartan going crazy in the booth. He knows Adfinim are just moments away from being able to claim this game 3 in a single elimination against one of the toughest teams out there.
So maybe a base race might be their best option. Luna is actually really good at sieging the T4s.
Newbie need to do something a little bit crazy. They start pushing into that tier two, but
I think crazy is the best choice that they have right now.
I mean, they're actually trying to run the Luna all the way back here. He doesn't actually have a TP scroll. Newbie are trying to push back on the Alchemist, slow him down at the bare minimum until Luna comes in from behind with that Eclipse.
Faith might die on the right side because these illusions.
These illusions just will not stop. Faith is dead between the combination of bugs, the illusions burned. Now Unite's going to be targeted. He doesn't have a BKB, so he's going to be whomped on by all these heroes. Bounced back by the jump. KP comes forward. He does manage to catch by Madara, but it doesn't matter. Newbie, they are so ineffective. They can't stop Advenom. Advenom going crazy inside the booth. Cheering, yelling. In one unified voice, this is Sparta, this is Advenom on the main stage, taking down Newbie.
A standing ovation from the crowd as they top Newbie 2-1 off the back of some very nice Bounty Hunter.